Hello. In the previous classes, we have seen Frege's sense and reference, how a sign designates its object. Today, we'll look into a different issue, that's on the notions of concept and object, how a word or how a term functions as concept or object. This is based on one of the essays of Frege named On Concept and Object. So, in the philosophy of language, the distinction between concept and object is attributable to the German philosopher Gottlob Frege. So, he's the one who differentiated between two functions of a term or two functions of a word. When it occurs in a proposition, how one and the same term or word or group of word, what we call term, can function either as a concept or as an object. Now, the detailed distinction between concept and object is explained by Frege in his 1892 article entitled On Concept and Object. That's the name of the article, that is On Concept and Object is the name of the article, in which he describes the distinction between concept and object. And I already sent you the article and hope you have read and understood that. This is just an explanation of what is given in that article. This appears as a reply to Benneckery on his remarks on Frege's distinction between concept and object that Frege expressed in his book, The Foundations of Arithmetic. Now, The Foundations of Arithmetic is one of the books of Frege in which he tries to explain the logical foundations of arithmetic. He is trying to explain how logic contributes for or how logic becomes the foundations of arithmetic. And if successful, this could have explained how mathematics or arithmetics functions, or how mathematics or arithmetic is logically founded, or how logic becomes the foundation of mathematical knowledge. But the attempt was not successful, and the attempt was later taken on by Whitehead and Russell. We'll see it later on. So in this book, Frege expressed this distinction between concept and object, and Benneckery made some remarks on his essay about Frege's distinction between concept and object in the book called or book entitled Foundations of Arithmetic. And this article, Concept and Object, is a reply to Benneckery's remarks. First, we'll be looking into the distinction between concept and object, how they are differentiated. Now, according to Frege, in a singular proposition, the proper name represents the object and the predicate represents the concept. In the propositions like Socrates is a philosopher, the Socrates is a philosopher consists of Socrates, which signifies the object Socrates, and is a philosopher, which signifies the concept of being a philosopher. In a singular proposition, or what we have studied as categorical propositions, there are two terms, the subject term as well as the predicate term. And what the categorical proposition is trying to explain, or what the singular proposition is trying to explain, is that the subject belongs to certain class, or the subject has certain attributes. Now, the subject refers to a particular entity. In the proposition, Socrates is a philosopher, the subject Socrates refers to a person, a particular individual, or we can call it an object, a thing. Not opposed to person, but the term Socrates refers to an entity, a thing called Socrates. Whereas, is a philosopher refers to some sort of properties. So, that's what is explained here. In a proper name represents the object and the predicate represents the concept. Is a philosopher is a predicate and it's some sort of attribute or property. So, it represents the concept. Now, Frege says that one and the same word may serve as both concept and object in different equations. So, it's not that simple that in any proposition, the subject term is an object and the predicate term is a concept. But in certain situations, the one and the same term can serve as both concept and object. And Frege is giving some examples for that. Frege explains that the difference between concept and object is not generally well observed in natural language. So what is the difference? The object represents a simple entity and the concept represents a property or attribute or a group. It represents a group. So Frege explains that this is not so obvious in ordinary language. It's not so clearly brought out in ordinary language discourses. Often the same word serves to designate both as concept and an object that falls under it. The same word can function in both the ways. He gives the example. In the sentence, this is a horse. The word horse is a concept. And it's very clear because this is a horse. And this refers to an object. It's pointing towards an object. This and horse refers to a concept, a property, an attribute called horse. And the same horse, when we use in the sentence, this horse is black. The word horse is used as an object. Here also, the word is horse. But when you say this horse, it refers to a particular horse and the word horse functions as an object. Frege gives a similar example. When he says whales are mammals. So their whales are apparently subject term, but it doesn't refer to a particular whale. So it's used as a concept. And mammals is again concept. So, in whales are mammals, both whales and mammals are used as concept. And the same whale, when occurs in the sentence, occurs in the proposition, the whale struck the ship. There, the whale is not a concept. The whale struck the ship. That's pointing towards a particular whale where it acts as an object. So, one and the same word, the whale can act as an object. In the proposition, the whale struck the ship, and in whales are mammals, it functions as a concept. So the word horse can be used as a concept by paraphrasing it as there is exactly one X at location Y, such that X is a horse and X is black. This horse is black. When you say this horse is black, and if you paraphrase it or if you symbolize it in quantification, and if you use quantification to symbolize this sentence, this horse is black, you can symbolize it as there is exactly one X at location Y such that X is a horse and X is black. This is the exact symbolization or paraphrasing of this sentence, this horse is black. In this case, we can see that the horse is used as a predicate that X is a horse and X is black. But this feature or this syntactical structure is not transparent in ordinary language. The ordinary language often conceals this syntactical structure or the grammatical structure of the word or the grammatical structure of the sentence. So we'll come to some features of concept and object, unsaturated and incomplete ones that Frege calls concept or relation. When you use some word as predicate, that horse is black, then the term black can be used for different other things. The pen is black, the cross are black. So like that, it can be used for many things. So it is unsaturated or it's not complete, it's incomplete. Because you can use many more, the same term you can use for many more subjects. So it always remains incomplete. The group always remains incomplete or it is unsaturated. And that's the feature of the concept. And proper names are objects while predicates are concept words. And when we say that the concepts are unsaturated, the objects are saturated. They refer to a particular thing. Nothing more can be added on that. When you said the horse is black, the horse, it's referring to a particular horse. You cannot add anything more to that. So it is saturated and complete. Proper names are objects while predicates are concepts. The proper name works as object. We have already seen that. And a proper name is any expression that serves to designate one and only one particular object. When you use it as proper name, it should designate one object and it should designate only one object. In these details, we will see in the next topic when we study Russell. Okay. So, proper name is any expression that serves to designate one and only one particular object. So, when it represents one and only one particular object, then it becomes saturated. The predicate designates a concept or a relation that can be ascribed to many proper names. This I already told, that's why it becomes unsaturated. Here, this is the major difference between the proper name and the predicate. The proper name can designate only one object, one particular object, whereas the predicate designates a concept or relation that can ascribe to many proper names. As I have explained in the case of black, horse is black, cross are black, pen is black, like that. Okay, this is one major difference between concept and object. And further differences, we'll see in the next class. Till then, bye. Thank you.